Good morning, buenos días. So, algunos anuncios. Everyone has a program. Todos tienen programa, ¿no? Good. We want everyone to participate as fully as possible. Estamos pidiendo todos a participar en la misa. Por ejemplo, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. El Señor esté con ustedes. Algo super fuerte, super fuerte. That's good. Y especialmente con las canciones también, lo más fuerte. No sé con ustedes, pero yo siempre tengo una tradición que cuando, solamente el obispo, cuando el obispo entra, un fuerte aplauso por él, para decir bienvenidos. Este es la misa en San Nicolás. So queremos dar un fuerte bienvenidos. Durante la ceremonia, during the ceremony, we ask everyone to be seated. Please don't walk around taking pictures. Por favor, háganos ese favor durante la ceremonia y queden en los bancos, que no saquen las fotos. Es una distracción. Después de la misa, inmediatamente después de la misa, está invitado a bajar y el obispo va a quedar por fotos con sus hijos y los ahijados inmediatamente después de la misa. So right after Mass, we actually go downstairs. The bishop will be free for pictures, but during the Mass, please stay right there in your seat. Obvio, it's very obvious, pero si tiene chicle, si tiene soda, si tiene cosas, por favor, tire afuera. If you have gum, if you have any liquids, please get rid of it now so that we prepare ourselves for the Mass. Bueno, yo soy el padre Ricardo y quiero decir bienvenidos a todos. Carolina está listo, practicando con ellos, maybe la gloria, algo. Perfecto. Uno fuerte, porque queremos fuerte, no queremos muertos, Cristo vive. So, vamos a cantar lo más fuerte posible. Let's sing as strong as we can at the Mass. Like ejemplo, el Señor esté con ustedes. Exacto, algo fuerte, fuerte, fuerte. Que San Nicolás está vivo. That's the parish of St. Nicholas is alive. So we want to be really strong. Thanks.
Entonces, el Gloria es muy sencillo. Dice, Gloria al Señor que reina en el cielo y en la tierra paz a los hombres que ama Él, que ama Él. Ese lo se ha cantado. Entonces, ensayémoslo una vez.
Gloria al Señor que reina en el cielo y en la tierra paz a los hombres que ama Él.
Esa es la melodía del coro para que me acompañen en el coro. De nuevo, vamos a cantarlo más fuerte, ¿listo? Y
Gloria al Señor que reina en el cielo y en la tierra paz a los hombres que ama Él.
Una vez más y terminamos, ¿listo? Dice,
Gloria al Señor que reina en el cielo y en la tierra paz a los hombres que ama Él.
Muchas gracias, muy bien.
Joy to the World, so it's
yeah,
just
the one, yeah.
Yeah, so. I don't know how the words fit in Spanish, but
okay, in Spanish y en English. As in
In
Spanish, this part.
The
English.
Yes, the first
one. The first in Spanish? Or
first in Spanish,
in Spanish.
First Spanish, then other English, then other Spanish.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And the tune is just. But it's a lot of words in Spanish, so.
It's
just like one syllable from.
The core estribillo in Spanish or in English?
It's just this one is just three verses. There's no chorus.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. Okay.
Yeah, verse. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Thank you.
Father's going to be recited.
Okay. Great.
Everything else could be checked.
Okay.
And whatever you plan, Spanish, English.
Yeah, it's okay.
So whatever you
it's
do
okay.
is good. It's just he likes to recite your Father.
The Lord be with us in some dimension.
The what?
The Lord be with you.
He may. Sometimes he may switch. So, okay?
Great, thank you.
And so we'll do the... most of the prayers I'm going to ask him to do, since the majority are Spanish, to do it in Spanish.
Right.
But the hints you ready, do whatever you plan on doing. And then the Eucharistic prayer will probably be in English from the Our Father.
Okay.
The Eucharistic prayer could probably going to be in English.
Okay, perfect. Great. Great. Thank you. Appreciate it. Beautiful.
Yeah.
Great.
And then in English.
Yes. Four verses, but they're very short. The psalm is like
Asia.
That's great.
Land of God, yeah.
Do you have Pispoto? Oh, you have great.
Offertory.
Great,
yeah.
We're going to do it with the organ, but do you want to just switch verses and do English, Spanish, English,
okay.
Spanish?
It's okay.
Okay, cool. So
in English?
Yeah, let's see. We could do, I could sing the first verse all the way through in English. So first verse, first refrain.
You first.
And then you want to do second? Okay, great.
Okay.
And then we'll just keep going until...
Yeah.
So there's enough time. We'll see. Maybe just two verses, maybe three. But just switch on and off. That'd be great.
Okay.
Great. And then that's you. And then for communion, you're doing...
The communion is in Spanish.
Oh, sorry,
in Spanish.
Perfect.
Lamb of God in Spanish.
Great. And then the closing hymn is Resucitó. And that's you. Great.
Yeah.
Awesome. Thank you. I am singing the 12 o'clock mass at St. Francis.
Yeah.
So
yeah. It's okay. No problem. No problem.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you for being here. We have some wonderful musicians with us here today. We have Carolina, who's going to be playing guitar and also singing a lot of our music in Espanol. I'll be singing a lot of things in English, and then we have David on the organ here. We'd like to just practice our psalm once. It's a very simple and short psalm today. It is psalm number 4. O Lord, let your face shine on us. So just, Lord, let your face shine on us. David can play that for us once on the organ, please. Beautiful. And with the words, it sounds like this. Lord, let your face shine on us. We can try that all together. Lord, let your face shine on us. Beautiful. One more time. Lord, let your face shine on us. Thank you. We have a beautiful mass prepared for you today. And all of the lyrics to everything we'll be singing are found in these beautiful programs, so please feel free to sing along. That being said, let us begin. Please stand and join us in singing our opening hymn, Hymn of Joy.
Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Amen.
Señor, te alabamos, Señor, te bendecimos.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter said to the people, "The God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, the God of our fathers, has glorified his servant Jesus, whom you handed over and denied in Pilate's presence when he had decided to release him. You denied the Holy and Righteous One and asked that a murderer be released to you. The author of life you put to death, but God raised him from the dead. Of this we are witnesses. Now I know, brothers, that you acted out of ignorance, just as your leaders did. But God has thus brought to fulfillment what he had announced beforehand through the mouth of all the prophets, that his Christ would suffer. Repent, therefore, and be converted, that your sins may be wiped away." The word of the Lord.
Lectura de la primera carta del apóstol San Juan. Hijitos míos, les escribo esto para que no pequen. Pero si alguien peca, tenemos como intercesor ante el Padre a Jesucristo, el justo. Porque Él se ofreció como víctima de expiación por nuestros pecados. Y no solo por los nuestros, sino por los del mundo entero. En esto tenemos una prueba de que conocemos a Dios, en que cumplimos sus mandamientos. El que dice, yo lo conozco, pero no cumple sus mandamientos, es un mentiroso, y la verdad no está en él. Pero en aquel que cumple su palabra, el amor de Dios ha llegado a su plenitud. Y precisamente en esto conocemos que estamos unidos a Él. Palabra de Dios. El Señor esté con ustedes. Lectura del Santo Evangelio según San Lucas. Cuando los dos discípulos regresaron de Emaús y llegaron al sitio donde estaban reunidos los apóstoles, les contaron lo que les había pasado en el camino y cómo habían reconocido a Jesús al partir el pan. Mientras hablaban de esas cosas, se presentó Jesús en medio de ellos y les dijo: la paz esté con ustedes. Ellos, desconcertados y llenos de temor, creían ver un fantasma. Pero él les dijo: no teman, soy yo. ¿Por qué se espantan? ¿Por qué surgen dudas en su interior? Miren mis manos y mis pies. Soy yo en persona. Tóquenme y convénzanse. Un fantasma no tiene ni carne ni huesos, como ven que tengo yo. Y les mostró las manos y los pies. Pero como ellos no acababan de creer de pura alegría y seguían atónitos, les dijo: ¿tienen aquí algo de comer? Le ofrecieron un trozo de pescado asado. Él lo tomó y se puso a comer delante de ellos. Después les dijo: lo que ha sucedido es aquello que les hablaba yo cuando aún estaba con ustedes, que tenía que cumplirse todo lo que estaba escrito de mí en la ley de Moisés, en los profetas y en los salmos. Entonces les abrió el entendimiento para que comprendieran las escrituras y les dijo: está escrito que el Mesías tenía que padecer y había de resucitar de entre los muertos al tercer día, y que en su nombre se había de predicar a todas las naciones,
comenzando por Jerusalén, la necesidad de volverse a Dios para el perdón de los pecados. Ustedes son testigos de esto. Palabra del Señor.
Gloria a ti, Señor Jesús.
Bishop Brennan, we welcome you to St. Nicholas Parish. Le doy un gran bienvenido al Monseñor Brennan a nuestra parroquia de Divina Misericordia aquí en la iglesia. Bishop, I would like to present to you these 15 young people who have been preparing for confirmation and are ready, and I ask them to please stand. And we should give them a round of applause. Thank you.
Iglesia de San Nicolás, pero es la primera vez que estoy con ustedes para celebrar la Eucaristía. Muchas gracias por esta oportunidad. Es una bendición muy especial por la confirmación de nuestros muchachos. Un día muy bendecido. ¡Feliz Pascua! Sí, coach. Todavía estamos en el tiempo de la Pascua, ¿no? Es el tiempo de la Pascua. Y acabamos de escuchar una otra cuenta de la resurrección de Jesús, su apariencia a sus discípulos, a sus amigos después de la resurrección en la noche de la Pascua. El día de la Pascua fue muy, pero muy ocupado por Jesús. Él hizo mucho en este día. Él no apareció en el cielo para saludarles. Hey, here I am. No, no. Como antes de morir, él tenía los encuentros con ellos. Y él quería renovar la amistad con ellos. Es muy, pero muy importante. Con su permiso, quiero hablar un poquito más en inglés a los muchachos, especialmente por la confirmación. And to you, congratulations today. What a beautiful day we have, and what a beautiful occasion that we celebrate. We here who believe in you very, very much are excited about you stepping up and saying yes to this beautiful gift. And here you are in the midst of this Easter season, right? These are glorious days, and we're still talking about the risen Jesus when we come to Mass. I want you to picture the scene that was just described to us in the Gospel today, right? So this is the night of Easter Sunday. We're going to go back in time, little by little, okay? Earlier that day, the women went to the tomb of Jesus. Remember this from Easter Sunday? And they were really sad, and they wanted to anoint the body of Jesus to show a little bit of tenderness after all the bad things that had happened. Just show a little bit of tenderness. And they get into the tomb and they say, wait a minute, the stone is gone? They didn't know how they were going to move the stone. They said, the stone is gone and there's nobody in here. And then they hear the news. The angels tell them, well, no, he's not here. He rose. Why are you looking for him among the dead? He's among the living. He's alive. Now, they didn't see him right away, so they were pretty confused, don't you think? And they went back to the guys. They went back to the apostles, and they said, Jesus isn't where he's supposed to be. And the angel said, he's alive. And they went, and they saw him, and they said, oh, man, I'm trying to figure this out. And then they remembered that he did talk about after 3 days maybe rising again, but they still didn't quite understand, right? So now they're back in that room. They're back in that room where they were before. They're still locked up. They're afraid. They're afraid because the same people who crucified him are out there still. They're confused because now what's going on? There's a part of them that's saying, could it really be that he is alive? They're still mourning his death. They're still sad about everything that happened on Good Friday. They're also a little disappointed. They're a little disappointed in him. They're a little disappointed in God. After all, they left everything to follow him. And they're disappointed in themselves. Remember Peter, right? Remember Peter? Peter, at the Last Supper, said to Jesus, look, Jesus, nothing bad's going to happen to you. They got to get past me first. Well, that's not exactly what he said. That's putting a little Brooklyn into it, okay? But Peter said, hey, Jesus, nothing bad's going to happen. I'm going to lay down my life for you. They got to get past me. Well, we all know how that worked out, right? Jesus said, Peter, you're going to deny me 3 times before the rooster crows, right? 3 times before the rooster crows. And Peter said, nope, 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 not going to happen. I'm with you all the way. Well, Peter was the first to run, right? Remember the last words that Peter spoke in Jesus' hearing, the last words that Jesus heard Peter say, I don't even know the guy. I don't even know him. Wow. How's that from hearing that from your friend, right? But, you know, Peter was scared. Peter was scared. Actually, some of us talked about this before. Who was the only apostle who stayed with Jesus to the very end? John, you got it. John was the loyal one. You got it, John. And John stayed there like Mary, his mother, and stood by Jesus. And we heard from John today in the second reading. John talks about us being children of God, being beloved by God, and how we love one another. John encourages us to have that same kind of loyalty and friendship for one another after Jesus. So anyway, Peter's wondering, there's part of Peter that's saying, oh, wow, could he still be alive? I mean, not still be alive, could he be alive again? Do I dare get my hopes up? And then he's thought, oh, man, what do I do when I see him? We didn't exactly leave on good terms. Meanwhile, we hear that two of his other disciples, so we're part of that group, two of his other followers, were walking to Emmaus, a town far away. They were walking to Emmaus. Now, that's a polite way of saying they turned their back on Jerusalem. They just said, the heck with it. They were so disappointed in everything that happened there that they said, I'm going back home. We're not going to bother anymore. Yeah, we heard about the empty tomb, but I'm not going to get my hopes up again just to get crushed. I did that once. So you can see what's going on with all of his friends, right, on Easter Sunday. And first he appears to those guys walking to Emmaus. And he lets them, they didn't recognize him. He lets them tell him all about their disappointments. Then he speaks to their hearts. And then in the breaking of the bread, they recognize him, right? So they go running back to the other apostles now to tell them the story. And while they're there, who comes into the room? Jesus. Because Jesus is really alive. Jesus stands there before them. He says, don't be so afraid. It's really me. He said, trust me. See my hands, my wounds. Give me something to eat. And he sat down and they gave him some baked fish. My goodness, I'll tell you something. If I rose from the dead after 3 days in the tomb, I hope you could come up with something better than some baked fish. But those weren't even his first words. You know what his first word was? The first word was, it was a Hebrew word, shalom. Peace be with you. La paz esté con ustedes. Shalom. We just say peace, but shalom is so, so much more than peace. Shalom is peace and well-being and everything you could possibly need. Shalom, my peace I give you. It means I count on you, I believe in you, I trust you. Those were Jesus' first words when he rose from the dead. You know, I don't know about you. If I were Jesus, I could forgive Peter for letting me down. But I'd have to let him know that he failed, you know? I think my first words to Peter would have been, hey, Peter, cock-a-doodle-doo, remember that? But not Jesus. Not Jesus. Jesus' words are shalom. I love you, you're my friends, and I believe in you. So that night, he renewed his friendship with them. That's what happened on Easter. He renews his friendship. Today, Jesus, the risen Lord, the one who rose from the dead, that means he's still alive, doesn't it? Jesus renews his friendship with you. Now, I say he renews his friendship not because you let him down. I say he renews his friendship because he already started friendship with you. He first called you his friend, his brother, when he first said he was your brother, when you were baptized, right? He first said it at baptism, but now he says it again. And he says it with that word of shalom. He says, peace be with you. As a matter of fact, that's part of confirmation, isn't it? Remember, you practice those things, right? Peace be with you and with your spirit, right? Well, that's not just me being nice. That's the greeting that Jesus gave to his apostles to renew his friendship. When I say that to you, it's Jesus renewing his friendship with you. And he doesn't just say, peace be with you, hey, good luck to you. That's not what he's saying. He's saying what I just said. I believe in you. And he's going to be with you always. After he spoke to them, he said to them, guys, we still got work to do. We have the name of God to all the world, beginning right here in Jerusalem. We got to keep proclaiming the gospel. People got to know the good news of the gospel. People need to know the good news of God's love for them, right? But he said, here's the story now. I'm going to continue to do it, but you're going to do it, and you're going to do it with me. I'm going to work through you. You're not just going to continue my work, but I'm going to work through you. You and I are going to be together. And I'm going to make you my witnesses in the world. I'm going to live within you. He said at the Last Supper, he said, if you love me, the Father and I, we will love you. We will send you the Holy Spirit, right? We will send you the Paraclete, the Holy Spirit, so that I can be with you always. When life is good, when life is easy, when life is fun, when life is difficult, when life is sad, no matter what the circumstance, I'm going to be with you because I can't give up on you. Because I can't stand not being part of your life, Jesus is saying. Just like he said to those apostles. He renews friendship with you and he says, no matter what, count on me, I'm going to be there. But also, he said, count on me being there with you, but I'm counting on you. Together, we're going to do great things. Together, we're going to bring the gospel, the good news, to people who need to hear it. together we're going to be witnesses. You're going to show the power of Jesus alive in the world. You're going to help people to know it. That's a real important job, so thanks for saying yes to it. You know, I don't know if any of you have seen it. There was a movie that just came out called Cabrini. Did anybody see La Película of Cabrini? It's a great, great movie. It was in the theaters. It's going to be streaming real soon. Okay, it'll be streaming, Cabrini. It's about St. Francis Xavier Cabrini. St. Francis Xavier Cabrini is a saint who worked right in New York and worked right here in Brooklyn. Did you know that? An actual saint worked here in Brooklyn. And in this movie, it's not just a great religious movie, it's a great movie. In this movie, you see how she comes in, how she starts in Lower Manhattan, and she works with the poorest people who were suffering. People, they were immigrants, people from Italy at the time. And a lot of them were orphaned because their parents died under tough circumstances. She worked, and a lot of people resisted her, but she was strong. And at one point in the movie, early on, when she comes with the sisters from Italy to help people, she has her poor health herself, and they're looking at all the work that's ahead of them and all the trouble they're having, and she says, "Now, sisters, listen, I'm not always going to be with you. I'm going to have to go away sometimes. But when I'm gone, you have to learn to face your fears." She didn't say don't ever be afraid, because things happen. She said you have to face your fears. And not just to get by, but to lead and to demonstrate how we can do all things in Him who strengthens us. That's my message to you today, too. We're going to have a lot of joy and maybe some scary things in our life, but you know what? We face those fears, not because it's easy, but because we're not alone, because Jesus Christ is with us every step of the way. Does that sound right? Right? You believe that? Jesus gives you His Spirit. We can face anything because of Jesus giving us His Spirit. And not just get by. You and I, we're not meant to just get by. We're made for greatness, aren't we? And the greatness is to show the power of Jesus. Sound good? You guys are with me? Okay. Then I'm going to ask you to please stand. Those who are being confirmed, I'm going to ask you now to renew the promises that you made on the day of your baptism, or more importantly, that your parents and godparents made in your name, in union with the whole church. Vamos a renovar las promesas del bautismo. Los muchachos van a renovar por la confirmación, pero en nuestros corazones hacemos lo mismo. Okay? Recordando el don del bautismo, el don de Dios en el bautismo y la amistad con Cristo. Jesús renueve la amistad hoy con ellos y con nosotros también. So I ask you, do you renounce Satan and all his works and all his empty promises? Do you believe in God, the Father, the Almighty, the Creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, who suffered death and was buried, who rose again from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who today, through the sacrament of confirmation, is given to you in a special way, just like he was given to the apostles on the day of Pentecost? Do you believe in the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? This is our faith. This is the faith of the church. We are proud to profess it. In Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen.
Catherine, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Jesus was made known in the breaking of the bread. Our minds and hearts are opened as we pray.
For the leaders of the church, and especially for Bishop Brennan, who is with us today, may the Holy Spirit strengthen them all with divine mercy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Para que los dirigentes del gobierno respeten la santidad de la vida desde la concepción hasta la muerte natural, roguemos al Señor.
Te rogamos, óyenos.
For the young people of our parish who receive the sacraments of confirmation today, may they remain close to Jesus and his church. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Para que los desempleados y los que sufren carencias reciban el consuelo de Dios, quien conoce todas las necesidades que hay en su corazón, roguemos al Señor.
Te rogamos, óyenos.
For the poor and for those who feel rejected by the society, may our parish community be a place of welcome and Christian support. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
En un momento de silencio vamos a presentar nuestras propias necesidades a la bondad de nuestro Padre. Roguemos al Señor.
Te rogamos, óyenos. God, our Father, our hearts burn within us as we listen to your only begotten Son. Accept the prayers of pilgrims on the path of life through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Please join in our offertory hymn, which can be found in our programs. Pescador de hombres, Lord, you have come to the seashore. We'll start in English, and second verse will be in Spanish. Lord, when you came to the seashore, you weren't seeking the wise or the wealthy, but only asking that I might follow. Oh, Lord. Hands for service. heart made for loving, my arms for lifting the poor and broken. Señor, me has mirado a los ojos, sonriendo, has dicho mi nombre en la arena, he dejado mi marca junto a ti. Buscaré otra
mar. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Receive, Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exalted church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been glorified. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he has destroyed our death, and by rising restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Santo, santo, santo es el Señor, Dios del universo. Llenos están el cielo y la tierra de tu gloria. Hosanna en el cielo.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, And once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Anunciamos tu muerte, Señor. Proclamamos tu resurrección. Ven, Señor. Ven, Señor Jesús.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Robert, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also your servants, whom you've been pleased to confirm today, by bestowing the Holy Spirit, and keep them in your grace.
Remember our brothers and sisters who fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coherent in eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, 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 por los siglos, amen. Amén, amén, amén. Amén.
Fieles a la recomendación del Salvador y siguiendo su divina enseñanza, nos atrevemos a decir: Padre nuestro que estás en el cielo, santificado sea tu nombre. Venga a nosotros tu reino, hágase tu voluntad en la tierra como en el cielo. Danos hoy nuestro pan de cada día. Perdona nuestras ofensas, como también nosotros perdonamos a los que nos ofenden. No nos dejes caer en la tentación, mas líbranos de mal. Líbranos de todos los males, Señor, y concédenos la paz en nuestros días, para que, ayudados por tu misericordia, vivamos siempre libres de pecado y protegidos de toda perturbación, mientras esperamos la gloriosa venida de nuestro Salvador Jesucristo.
El poder y la gloria por siempre, Señor.
Señor Jesucristo, que dijiste a tus apóstoles, la paz les deo, mi paz les doy. No tengas en cuenta nuestros pecados, sino la fe de tu iglesia, y conforme a tu palabra concédele la paz y la unidad, tú que vives y reinas por los siglos de los siglos.
Amén.
La paz del Señor esté siempre con ustedes.
Y con tu espíritu.
Con alegría nos damos un saludo.
Paz. Paz.
Cordero paz. De Dios, paz. Que quitas el pecado, ten piedad. De nosotros, ten piedad de nosotros. piedad de nosotros, ten piedad de nosotros. Cordero de Dios que quitas el pecado, danos la
Este es el Cordero de Dios que quita el pecado del mundo. Dichosos sus invitados a la cena del Señor. Señor, no soy digno de que entres en mi casa, pero una palabra tuya bastará para sanarme. Cristo, el cuerpo de Cristo.
El que no ama a sus hermanos. este convite.
Dirige, Señor, tu mirada compasiva sobre tu pueblo, al que te has dignado renovar con estos misterios de vida eterna, y concédele llegar un día a la gloria incorruptible de la resurrección por Jesucristo, nuestro Señor. Amén.
Por sentarse, please be seated. Really want to congratulate all those who received their confirmation. You should stand up and turn around. So we give you another round of applause. Thank you. You can be seated. Also, we want to thank all those who formed them in the faith, especially you, the parents, the godparents, the sponsors who are here today. Congratulations, and thank you for bringing them to this step of their faith. Un fuerte aplauso a los padres y padrinos. And we want to thank those who coordinate our religious education here for many, many years. Amelia has been our coordinator for faith formation. Now we have also Gianna and Sonia, who has been one of our catechists. We'd like to ask Amelia and Sonia and Gianna to come forward, and we have a small little token for them. Un fuerte aplauso. We have the flowers, we'll give them to you later.
Let me thank you. Muchas gracias. Thank you so much for what you do. Thank you. And thank you for everything. Thank you. God bless. And here they come. Wait.
Very nice. Thank you. Y, of course, finalmente queremos dar un fuerte acción de gracias por la presencia de nuestro obispo, Monseñor Brennan, el pastor de nuestra diócesis de Brooklyn Queens. Right after the Mass, inmediatamente después de esta misa, all of you, the candidates, will follow the bishop out. You'll be the last ones out, and we'll be going downstairs for some pictures. Everyone is welcome downstairs. We have some light refreshments after the Mass. So, inmediatamente después de la bendición, el Monseñor va a salir y vamos a sacar las fotos abajo y hay refrescos por todos. Todos están invitados. Feliz domingo a todos. Gracias.
If I could just tag on to Father Rick's words of appreciation to all those who brought you to this day and all those who made today's celebration so beautiful, so prayerful, so reverent, and also his congratulations to all of you. I want to thank Father Rick as well, and thank you for your pastoral leadership and for your warm welcome. You know, I was confirmed on May 13th, 1975, by a bishop named Bishop McGann in my home parish of Our Lady of Perpetual Help, which is on the South Shore of Suffolk County, a little further east of here. 14 years later, the same bishop, Bishop McGann, ordained me a priest at the Cathedral of St. Agnes in Rockville Center. Wouldn't it be great if in 14 years, give or take, we were here in Divine Mercy celebrating a religious profession of a sister or a brother or a first mass of a priest? Wow, what a blessing that would be. But you know what? That's not so impossible. God's doing amazing things. We have some great men in our formation. Father Pedro's a young priest, right? You had 5 years? 5 years ordained, all right? So he's set like you, confirmation, and grew up in the faith. We have, last Saturday, I was up in Massachusetts for a sister from Long Island who made her religious profession. And we have a sister, Sister Jennifer Castillo from St. Rita's Parish in Brooklyn, who entered into the Salesian Sisters and is doing great things. Just this July, she sat like you, was confirmed in these churches. But let me say something to you, all of you. God is calling each and every one of you. And God is doing amazing things through each and every one of you. I always say God's doing amazing things in Brooklyn and Queens. And now with this gift of the Spirit, God's doing amazing things through you. So today on your confirmation day, I ask you, I beg you, remember that the bishop begged you. I'm begging you, please be as generous and as courageous in responding to wherever God calls you, just like you're generous and courageous today in accepting this gift. Sound good? Good. The Lord be with you. El Señor esté con ustedes. Espíritu.
Incline la cabeza para la bendición. Inclinamos la cabeza para la bendición.
May God the Father Almighty bless you, whom he has made his adopted sons and daughters, reborn from water and the Holy Spirit. May he keep you worthy of his fatherly love. Amen. Que el unigénito de Dios que prometió a su iglesia la presencia continua del Espíritu de la verdad los bendiga y los confirme en la confesión de la fe verdadera. Amen. May the Holy Spirit, who kindles the fire of charity in the hearts of disciples, bless you, lead you blameless, and gather as one into the joy of the kingdom of God. Amen.
Amen.
Y a todos ustedes los aquí presentes, los bendiga Dios Todopoderoso, Padre, Hijo y Espíritu Santo. Amén.
La misa ha terminado, pueden ir en paz.
Gracias.
Que resucitó, 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 aleluya, 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 resucitó. Resucitó, 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 aleluya, 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 resucitó.
Hi, David. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you. God bless you.
Dejemos este micrófono acá. Esto lo dejamos así quieto, ¿sí?